Good evening and welcome to Campaign 2012, a live BUTV Web Street special on this Super Tuesday. I'm Davis Van Opdorp.
And I'm Sarah Zundenom. Tonight we will have the returns, the reaction, and the analysis from the biggest day of voting yet in the GOP presidential campaign. Here's the latest. Tonight, Super Tuesday, after the biggest voting day in the presidential campaign, this is what we know. The race isn't over, but GOP candidate Mitt Romney wins the lion's share of delegates. He and Gingrich find that there's no place like home, or home states, of Massachusetts and Georgia. And Santorum hung on to Romney's coattails, winning three states and still fighting in Ohio, where at this time, results are just too close to call. Even Ron Paul, the Republican's outlier, could do well enough in Alaska and North Dakota and give a respectable showing in Virginia, enough to keep his quirky campaign alive. Mitt Romney scored an easy and unexpected primary win in Massachusetts, where polls closed at 8 p.m. tonight. With 32% of precincts reporting, Mitt Romney leads with 72%, Rick Santorum is in second place with 12%, Newt Gingrich at 5%, and Ron Paul at 9%. It's clear that Romney handily beat Ron Paul, Rick Santorum, and Newt Gingrich in its home state. The other candidates put little money or effort in Massachusetts. Tonight, GOP frontrunner Mitt Romney is back in his home state of Massachusetts, where he was once governor and resident. Romney returned to the Bay State this afternoon and is now at the Westin Hotel, where BUTV reporter Justin Bork is reporting live via Skype. Justin?
President Obama.
USA! 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 USA!
You know, when he was campaigning, President Obama said he'd create jobs. But for 36 straight months, unemployment has been above 8%. And he's also said he'd cut the deficit in half. And he's doubled it. I mean, as you know, the debts today are too high, the opportunities are too few. And we've seen enough of this president over the last 3 years to know that we don't need another five of this president. That's for sure. Look, I said... This president's run out of ideas. He's run out of excuses, and in 2012, we're going to get him out of the White House.
I'm live from Mitt Romney's campaign event in Boston, where he just finished thanking the capacity crowd. The big focuses of tonight's speech, though, were the economy and Obama. Here's what he had to say. General election a little bit. And he also mentioned the economy. Let's see what he had to say.
The Belmont vote is where Mitt Romney is now.
Mitt Romney is back home in Belmont after months on the campaign trail. He came to the Beach Street Senior Center at about 5 p.m. today to cast his ballot in the Massachusetts primary. Belmont residents are proud of Romney and are excited to see him back home after his time campaigning.
And I see he signed your visor. You want to show it to
us? Yes, this is the second time he's been to Belmont. He visited us during his last attempt, and we met him down at Belmont Center, and today he was here, so I came down to see him again and wish him good luck.
I love it, Romney! I love it, Romney!
In a press conference held after he cast his ballot, Mitt Romney expressed his happiness to be home.
It's been, I guess, a couple of months,
since we've been home in Massachusetts. We're looking forward to sleeping in our own bed tonight and being with family.
41 delegates are at stake in Massachusetts, and Romney hopes to take a win in his home state.
I think it's really hard to predict what's going to happen tonight. I'm hoping for a good win here in Massachusetts, and what happens elsewhere, I don't know, but I think we'll pick up a lot of delegates. And this is a process of gathering enough delegates to become the nominee, and I think we're on the track to have that happen.
We're still working on the live shot from the Westin Hotel, but that was Keisa McCoy reporting from Mitt Romney's hometown of Belmont.
Meanwhile, in Ohio, the race has been pretty tight so far. Here is what CNN is currently reporting in the swing state. Well, it's really tight, like I said. With 49% of the precinct reporting, 38% of the vote went to Rick Santorum, with Mitt Romney close behind in 36%. Newt Gingrich is at 15%, and Ron Paul is right behind at 9%. So it definitely will be interesting to see how this primary will wind down. Rick Santorum is in Ohio, and here's what he has to say about what transpired today so far.
Maine is about the towns that have been left behind and the families that made those towns the greatest towns across this country. This was a big night tonight. Lots of states. We're going to win a few. We're going to lose a few. But as it looks right now, we're going to get at least a couple of gold medals and a whole passel full of silver medals.
So what has the climate been in Ohio? BUTV's own Stephanie Jarvis was able to catch up with Greg Holder, a contributor from the University of Cincinnati, who is there to give us the scoop in the swing state.
I think a win for Santorum in Ohio means more than a win would for Romney, that's for sure. I think Santorum, for better or worse, is on his last legs right now. Romney's outspending him. Romney's catching up to him when he's had these early leads throughout the race. And I think if Santorum can scrape one together here, I think it speaks volumes about his candidacy. He is from Pennsylvania, which makes you think that if there's one place he's going to rally, it probably will be in Ohio. That being said, I don't think it should be discounted because, you know, Romney's clearly had the momentum over the last few days. He's closed the gap. But if Santorum can come back today and pull something out, I think it'll be huge. And I think it really swings towards his favor going forward. Now, does that mean he becomes the favorite? No. But I think it definitely gives credence to his staying around and fighting going forward.
Now how the vote totals in Tennessee, and CNN reports coming up. With 36% reporting, Rick Santorum leads with 40%. Mitt Romney is in second with 28%. Newt Gingrich follows closely with 22%. And trailing behind is Ron Paul at 8%. CNN is also reporting now with numbers from Georgia. With 47% reporting, Mitt Romney is at 23%, Rick Santorum at 21%, Newt Gingrich is leading at 49%, and Ron Paul once again trailing at 6%. Candidate Newt Gingrich is the winner of his home state in Georgia. He continues his campaign and fights against the energy policy that he believes needs to be improved in order to change the efficiency of the country.
Remember when it was Tim Pawlenty who was going to crowd me out? And remember then when it was Michelle Bachmann? And then it was our good friend Herman Cain the first time? And then for a brief moment it was Donald Trump almost? And then it was our good friend Rick Perry. And then it was Herman Cain the second time. And now it's Santorum. And you just can't quite get across to him. It's all right. There are lots of bunny rabbits that run through. I'm the tortoise. I just take one step at a time.
Ron Paul hasn't won many delegates, but that hasn't stopped the former Texas congressman from spreading his message. Paul spoke to supporters earlier tonight in Fargo, North Dakota, about what makes him stand out from the rest of the Republican nominees.
If you look at the candidates today, there is very little difference except for one. The rest of the candidates support the status quo. Foreign policies never change. Monetary policy doesn't change. There's no challenge to the Federal Reserve System. And most of all, there's no desire to protect personal liberty, personal privacy.
Now let's take a look in Vermont, the other New England state in this Super Tuesday. CNN reports that 50% of the precincts reporting that 39% of the vote went to Mitt Romney, with Ron Paul just ahead of Rick Santorum with 26% to 22%. Newt Gingrich is far behind with 9%. Mitt Romney will win Vermont. It would give him the state's 14 available delegates. BUT reporter Marie Tordo just turned from southern Vermont with a look at Super Tuesday's one city.
Good morning!
Super Tuesday in Vermont kicked off at 9 a.m. with 17 delegates up for grabs for the GOP primary election. Residents in the city of Brattleboro headed to Union High School to cast their votes in the town's local election as well as the national presidential primary. Brattleboro is the home to nearly 6,000 registered voters. Election officials speculate that about 25% of those voters will come out to vote and will also have to declare their political party before picking up a ballot.
You know, this is unusual for us because of the political party declaration. Vermont normally allows people to vote in privacy and not declare parties.
Even the newest of voters came out to pencil in their opinion.
It was really exciting when I found out that I could vote in the presidential primaries, even though I'm only 17 right now.
While the number of outside supporters was limited, Brattleboro's Jim McConnell makes his vote known.
Yes, Ron Paul! Absolutely!
Many voters agree that Mitt Romney may take their state in the Republican primary. But will voters also consider Rick Santorum?
No. People are just too, he's too much in people's business, and
that's not the Vermont way.
That's not what Vermont people are about.
With 17 delegates at stake, Vermont may not be the largest state at risk, but remains crucial on Super Tuesday. Romney must obtain at least 50% of the vote to lock up 14 of the 17 delegates, but residents here say that Ron Paul may not be trailing far behind. Reporting from Brattleboro, Vermont, I'm Marie Tordo for BUTV.
Vermont has the smallest number of Super Tuesday delegates at 17. Alaska offers today's next smallest poll at 27.
CNN reports that Mitt Romney wins the Virginia primary. Now, only Romney and Ron Paul appeared on the ballot in Virginia because Santorum and Gingrich failed to meet the filing deadline. Although it has not received a lot of attention during the Republican primaries, Virginia will be a key swing state in the general election. Earlier today, BUTV's Rachel Walford was in Northern Virginia speaking to the voters.
My top three priorities are jobs, less taxes, and less government. I'm sick and tired of them regulating everything.
Republicans across the nation are coming out to vote on these issues. And in Virginia, it's no different. The most recent polls have Mitt Romney up 43% from Ron Paul.
It's still going to be a fight for delegates. But he's amassing those delegates over time, and he'll eventually be the nominee.
Ron Paul has supporters in Virginia after campaigning last week in Springfield.
I was for Ron Paul before he, became popular.
But Ron Paul might not be popular enough to bring out more voters and keep Romney from winning the state's 49 delegates.
Although we've probably seen more than we expected. We didn't... You don't expect that many in a primary because it's half the normal registered voters would come and vote, and then, you go down from there.
I think, if you're a good Republican, you're going to come out and vote, period. Because, we need to have people come out and at least show their support for the party.
We have encountered some diehard Republicans despite low voter turnout today. Virginia historically picks the party's nominee, and Mitt Romney is the projected winner today. In Virginia, reporting for BUTV, this is Rachel Walford.
Historically, Virginia has been a Republican stronghold for presidential elections. In the last 10 elections, Virginia has gone Republican every year except in 2008 when Barack Obama won it. And in 2012, this swing state will be key to both parties' road to the White House.
Well, in Virginia and across the rest of the Super Tuesday states, millions of voters flocked to cast their primary vote. On the campus of Boston University, however, student presence at polls left much to be desired. BUTV's Vanessa Mashania has more on why some of the BU students did not cast their vote.
It's decision time in the Bay State and a chance for Boston University students to speak up about their concerns and predictions for the 2012 primaries.
I have a lot of confidence. Romney will win Massachusetts.
As a Democrat, I would love to see Santorum or Gingrich make a run.
I think Santorum is so out of touch with young people that I think younger people are more likely to go for Mitt because he seems a little more moderate.
I'm a big Ron Paul fan, I can tell you that much.
The opinions were strong and varied campus-wide, but many students shied away from expressing them at the ballot box.
I mean, I haven't really heard about anyone going out and voting.
I don't think people care about the primary at all. I don't know anyone that's voting in the primary. And I know lots of students that say they don't even need to vote in the election because Obama's just going to win.
I'm a poli sci major, and as much as I've learned about voting and everything and all the classes I've taken, my vote really doesn't matter that much.
Students considered the pending results to be out of their hands and instead would focus their energy on a race they considered to be more important.
Because voting in Massachusetts, I think Romney's going to win, and I don't think that my vote even really matters.
I think a lot of young people are really going to assume that it's going to be Obama, so I don't think it really matters to them.
In terms of November next year, I think we'll get a decent amount of support.
From Alaska to Massachusetts, Super Tuesday is pivotal in figuring out who the Republican nominee will be on the 2012 ballot. And Boston's over 400,000 registered voters has pull in figuring that out. But most student voters on BU's campus are saving their vote come the big show in November. Reporting for BUTV from Kenmore Square, I'm Vanessa Mashania.
And we will return with our political analyst, Dean Tom Fiedler, to help us sort out what this all means and what the road forward is for the Republican looks like.
But first, here are the sights and sounds of Super Tuesday here on the campus of Boston University.
I feel like a lot of people just feel really far removed from the elections and feel like they don't really have a say or that their opinion doesn't really matter.
It's more of a hassle for me to vote and go and get the ballot and do all that.
I do not vote in Massachusetts and I have been following my home states, so I have no idea.
If I was registered Republican, I still don't know if I'd vote because the Republican primary has become such a media show.
This can't be happening.
Of course it's not happening. Armored car. Listen, having money isn't about luck. Make your own coffee, save $1,000 a year. Feed me.
Feed the pig.
Sex, don't give up on birth control either. There are more methods than you think. Find yours at bedsider.org.
Thank you.
Welcome back to Campaign 2012. Our very own Justin Bork is standing by at the Westin Hotel with a GOP representative. Justin?
Initial results from Idaho, when he's 50-60% Idaho. So he's going to have four victories tonight. Ohio right now is supposed to call. The other thing about Ohio is he's going to get a huge number of delegates out there. He's going to run second in Georgia to Newt Gingrich. He's going to run second in Tennessee and second in Oklahoma. He's going to get delegates out of all those states. So I think he's going to be the big winner in terms of delegates tonight, which is what it's all about on the quest to win 45.
What do you think it will take going forward in order for Romney to wrap up his primary election?
Well, you're going to keep, it's a long slog, and that's the great thing about his campaign is he built it as a 50-state campaign. They can go compete in each jurisdiction if you don't win, but still get delegates. And I think that's what's going to continue on in the next days, weeks, and months ahead.
Now, if you were to win, how do you favor his chances against Barack Obama in the general election?
Well, I think he's going to have a very good chance against Barack Obama in the general election. I mean, again, it's a long way away, and I think he said in his remarks that it's going to be good days, it's going to be bad days.
Thank you very much. That was Brad Jones, once again, the minority leader for the Massachusetts House of Representatives. And of course, I'm Justin Bork, signing off for BUTV News.
Thanks, Justin. And now for a quick update in Tennessee. With 36% of the precincts reporting, it looks like Rick Santorum has taken almost a 2-1 lead over Mitt Romney. Newt Gingrich not far behind Romney with 22%, and Ron Paul is still trailing behind with only 8% of the vote.
And now let's check back at what's got to be a victory party at the Westin Hotel for GOP candidate Mitt Romney.
All right.
We have Dean Tom Fiedler here in studio with us to answer some of the most important questions of the night.
Well, it looks, Tom, all of your experience, you've been covering elections since 1972 with Nixon and McGovern and all the way up to Bush and Gore. So, based on what you've seen tonight, what have you seen tonight that stuck out at you?
Well, I think the most important thing, if you look at the scope of Super Tuesdays, the first Super Tuesday really was established in 1976 and has gone forward. And the party set them up with the deliberate purpose of this being the culmination of a primary. It's not in the party's interest to have a primary campaign go on and on and on. There's too much money spent, too much blood spilled in a symbolic sense. And so Super Tuesday was going to be the place where everything got settled. What's happened here, and I think what'll be unusual about the Republican primary in 2012, is we don't see this race settled. It's going to go on. Everybody has seemed to have done at least enough to justify going forward. Newt Gingrich out of Georgia, that gives him enough oxygen to go on next week. Two more southern states will vote, Alabama and Mississippi. We don't know what'll happen in Ohio tonight, but at least in the popular vote, but it's likely that Romney will get the most delegates. So he will go forward with the delegate lead. But you're still going to have Rick Santorum hanging on to him. Santorum's done very well. He's had Tennessee, he's got Oklahoma. He very well could pull out Ohio here. And then he also has some states coming up ahead. And then on the outsides, you've got Ron Paul, who just kind of goes forward and forward. So this race is going to, this well could go into June, and the nightmare scenario for Republicans would be to have this go all the way to the convention in Tampa at the end of August, and then you'd have a real collision. But there's no resolution tonight.
So Romney is leading the delegate count right now, as he has been this for the past couple months. What can you say about Paul, Santorum, and Gingrich? Do you think that their campaigns are going to fizzle out anytime soon? I mean, you mentioned that it could go until June, but do you think that this could go until August?
Well, not for all of them. I think with Gingrich is going to, I think, get a little bit of a boomlet out of tonight. Of course, commanding victory in Georgia, his sort of home state. He represented it as a congressman. And he's got three southern states coming up pretty quickly with Alabama, Mississippi, and Louisiana. And Texas, if he can survive another another month. So there's enough out there for him to go. But the reality is he will end up probably a distant third at best, and so he won't be very viable. Santorum is really the one that's just going to kind of hang on, and Romney is trying to shake him, but so far with no success. So I think we'll see Santorum go for it. If Santorum ends up winning tonight in Ohio, even though he doesn't win in the delegate lead, it will be a major blow to Romney, and the media reports out of this will end up reporting this as a loss for Mitt Romney. That clearly could have an effect going forward.
Now, as you know, and as everybody knows, they've been crawling over each other to try to get that Republican seat against Barack Obama. So do you think that the Republican Party can converge around whoever is the nominee against Obama?
Well, there will obviously be some settling, because the Republican Party is going to have to go to whoever is left there. The question is the enthusiasm, and the biggest test for whoever the nominee is in the Republican primary is you've got to unite your base, and then you've got to reach out and appeal to the independents who will create the majority in November. Right now, independents don't like the Republicans. The highest favorability rating of any Republican is below 40%. In other words, more than 60% of the independents don't like any Republican at all. It's going to be a major challenge for the Republican base to come together, grab independents, and make a serious fight against President Obama in November. It's a real tough road.
Well, thank you very much, Dean Fiedler. It's always great to have one of Comm's finest giving us
right.
Our
thank allowance. You very much.
Thank
a pleasure.
You very much.
Meanwhile, President Barack Obama is reminding voters and GOP candidates that he is still a commander-in-chief. Obama has accused Republicans' critics of beating the drums of war when it comes to the threat of nuclear Iran. He has made the comments during a formal news conference and Super Tuesday this afternoon, which unfortunately we don't have. GOP candidate Mitt Romney has blasted the president for what he called procrastinating in Iran.
What issues mattered most to the Super Tuesday voters in Massachusetts? BUTV reporter Vivian Leung has the story on exit polls from a Back Bay polling place today.
It's Super Tuesday, Massachusetts, and Bay State voters are casting their ballots at voting stations like Ward 5, Precincts 7, 8, and 9 in the Boston Public Library. Now, this is a small yet diverse sample of exit poll results that show that the top issues in the Bay State are the economy and electability.
Economy and our rising deficit and debt levels are probably the most important issues for the time being.
Well, I absolutely agree with that. I think the debt is a major problem, and we need to deal with that.
And voters like Andrea Lance are banking on Mitt Romney to improve the nation's budget deficit and help investors regain consumer confidence in the market.
I think that he's done very well in business. I think that he believes in accountability.
He will give us a sort of sense of comfort that he's going to do that. It'll give us more confidence to spend and buy. And I think that's gone at the
most
moment.
Most importantly, Republicans want a candidate to beat the president in the 2012 election. And that person happens to be the former Bay State governor.
You know, people are trying to sort of suggest that he isn't sort of connecting with people, but I don't see that, actually. I see that as people get to know him better, they will understand that being president is bringing people together, and that takes some form of moderation in your demeanor. You can't promise things to people that you can't deliver. And I think it's very dangerous to promise hope and change and all that sort of thing and then not be able to deliver, and people have seen that.
This long and contentious GOP battle may hurt the party's chances in defeating President Barack Obama, but the Romney machine proves to be unstoppable in Massachusetts. Bay State voters are hoping that the former governor's reputation as a turnaround guy will improve the nation's economy. Reporting for BUTV 10, I'm Vivian Leung in Boston.
Massachusetts Republicans are hoping to lock their traditionally left-leaning state as a red state in November. The race between the final four is narrowing down to a brutal war between the social conservative and moderate Republican. The former Bay State governor prevailed in this battle because Massachusetts chose to focus on the economy instead of social issues. And when we return, what not to say on the campaign trail. You'll hear that moment next.
But first, we once again want to show you the sights and sounds of Super Tuesday, this time in Belmont. candidate Mitt Romney's hometown.
I've been a Belmont resident since 1973.
Could you see yourself supporting Mitt Romney at all? Or?
No. He's just not part of the mainstream middle class. He just can't think like that. He just can't.
He has been allegedly seen across the street at the restaurant. Very, very nice restaurant. We were kind of hoping he'd walk through. I know he must have parked out back, but he doesn't drink.
Hey.
Ready to go?
Yeah, but the fire's not out.
Close enough.
Close enough? If it's too hot to touch, it's too hot to leave. I mean, the next thing you know, you've torched our whole neighborhood.
Which is why we're not going anywhere?
Exactly.
9 out of 10 wildfires are caused by humans.
Only you can prevent wildfires.
Do you like this top?
So gay.
Really?
Yeah, it's totally gay.
You know, you really shouldn't say that.
Say what?
Well, say that something's gay when you mean it's bad. It's insulting. What if every time something was bad, everybody said, oh, that's so girl wearing a skirt as a top?
Oh, you are.
Those are cute jeans, though. When you say that's so gay, do you realize what you say? Knock it off.
So, same time next week?
Well, of course.
Put away a few bucks, feel like $1 million. For free tips to help you save, go to
Feed the Pig.
Welcome back to Campaign 2012, a live BUTV live web stream on this Super Tuesday. Let's update you once again on the rest of tonight's action. And we're going back to Ohio, where 70% of the precincts are reporting, and Mitt Romney has made it one percentage point right behind Rick Santorum. Newt Gingrich is still behind at 15%, and Ron Paul is at 9%.
We have another state update for you, and this time it's Alaska. Let's see what CNN has to report for us. Well, it seems like Massachusetts is the update, reporting at 66%. Mitt Romney is 56%, number one. Ron Paul is at 14%, Newt Gingrich is at 12%, and trailing is Rick Santorum at 5%. Finally, on this Super Tuesday, a reminder that even those husbands running for president need to choose their words carefully, especially when you're talking about your wife. We'll have that clip tomorrow for you, but I think it was something along the lines of poking fun at his wife's weight.
Ooh, that is definitely a no-no in my book. Well, this campaign has been really exciting, especially in Ohio.
Yeah, I mean it's been pretty close this whole time, but that's it for our Campaign 2012 special, a production of Boston University News Service and BUTV. Thank you everyone for all of your help. I'm Sarah Zendenom.
And I'm Dave Spinopdorp. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll leave tonight with the sights and sound of Super Tuesday in the neighborhood of Boston.